To please join the stage with Mr. Mariwala, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much.
So I think, Savita, you just mentioned, and I think we wanted to take the opportunity that Mr. Mariwala is with us to felicitate our jury team. This is a group of individuals who, as you can imagine, are extremely busy. And Mr. Mariwala said that building culture takes time and there are no shortcuts. I may say that building great properties or great institution also takes time and there is no shortcuts. So this is really the team who have supported us, believed in us, and really spent a lot of their personal time and their, you know, their commitment to help us put this together. So let's
thank you. Ahead. Thank you, Esther. So ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Mr. Dwarkar Nath, Director, Group Human Capital at Max India. Please join us.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Here we are. You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Please, may I request you to stay back, Mr. Dwarkar Nath? May I request you to stay back? Thank you so much. Can I have Dr. Akhil Bushrai, CEO Akhil Bushrai Consulting, to please join us on the stage. Let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen. Please. Thank you. May I request Dr. Bushrai to please stay back on the stage. Joining him, Raja, CHRO Tata SIA. May I request Raja to please join us on the stage. May I request Jacob to join us, Chief People Officer at Apollo Hospitals. With a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Let the applause keep coming in. Thank you. Joining them, Anuranjita Kumar, MD and CHRO, City South Asia. Let's hear it for Anu, please. Joining them, Prabhakar, Vice President, HR, Agribusiness Division and ITC. Let's hear it for Prabhakar, ladies and gentlemen. May I request Meenal Jadhav to join us, Director of Talent Management at Schneider Electric. Let's hear it for Meenal, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Joining them, Kamlesh Dangi, Group Chief People Officer at UTI Mutual Fund. Let's hear it for Kamlesh. Joining everybody, Shalini Pillai, Head of People Performance and Culture at KPMG. Let's hear it for Shalini, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together for Yuvraj Srivastava, CHRO MakeMyTrip.com. We could not have Shalini Lal, former director, Deutsche Bank, and Gajendra Chandel, CHRO Tata Motors, joining us this evening. But we'll definitely have a lot of regards to share with us for this evening. And we definitely convey our gratitude to them separately as well. May I request Anu Zakaria to join us on the stage, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, there we are. Here we are.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. It has been an awesome 5 years of journey. It wouldn't have been possible without your support. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. A big round of applause for all our jury members, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you, Harsh. Thank you, jury members.
Thank you.
May I request Anu and Esther to kindly stay back on the stage. Thank you so much.
Over to you, Anu and Esther.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Great. So I think we are ready to get started.
Indeed,
but I
we
wanted
are.
Anu to set the context a little bit, take us through the process. We'll also share the video with you, and then we'll get started.
Thank you, Esther. I must say it's been an absolute privilege working with People Matters over the last 5 years, 10,000 applicants, and you must really see it from our vantage point to see so many, you know, HR professionals from the industry across different regions, different organizations, all aligned with one common thread, which is a very deep passion for the profession that we represent, that we belong to, and I'm sure that's passion that's shared in this room as well. Would you agree?
Yes.
Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you for your passion. And it's been amazing to see over the years how the profile, the caliber, the experience, the skill sets of HR professionals has also seen an evolution over time. And I must say that this year has been again a revelation, with so many jury members saying that it was challenging to really hone in on the winners from the pool of equally deserving candidates. So thank you for your continued passion and interest in being part of this initiative.
So let's have a look at the process video. So then for some of you who may not be aware of the 8-month, six-stage process that these individuals have gone through in detail. Can we have the process video, please?
So Diria was extremely happy to partner with People Matters to select the top emerging HR leaders in India.
Hundreds of HR professionals, directly, indirectly, very senior people, are nurturing these initiatives, are spending their personal time and effort to really create a transformation in the young community of HR.
Stage 1. Candidates register online and fill an online application form. The shortlisted applicants progress to DDI's adaptive reasoning test, which is a brief online assessment of one's cognitive ability. The ability to reason, draw accurate conclusions, and make effective decisions.
And one of the primary advantages of this tool is that we're looking for the personality attributes and dispositions that makes an individual succeed in a role as a leader.
Stage 3. The shortlisted candidates undergo DDI's online leadership assessment. This is a tool to identify the candidate's readiness to take managerial roles, measuring critical competencies such as planning and organizing, problem analysis, judgment, managing relationships, customer focus, facilitating change, and others. Stage 4. In this phase, the shortlisted candidates answer predetermined questions. Vetting the insights. This stage will involve scrutiny of the information provided by the shortlisted candidates by AMS Inform. Stage 5A. The shortlisted candidates then move to stage 5, appearing for another challenging assignment in the form of a business simulation case study. This assessment further evaluates the shortlisted candidates on their ability to demonstrate a keen understanding of basic business operations and the organizational levers that help driving the business. Stage, face off with the panel. This stage will include a one-on-one meeting of the jury with the finalists, leading into identifying the emerging future HR leaders of the year. The jury then comes together and finally recognizes the winners.
So I think this type of initiatives brings to surface people who are very high potential.
Are You In The List is nurturing of youngsters so that when they become elders, they start nurturing youngsters themselves.
Our objective was really to bring the community together, but we never expected that, you know, it will be something that will actually create a revolution in the space.
They are the future of the Indian HR, the people power of the moment. They set the momentum. They are revolutionaries, the visionaries, and the mavericks. And this moment is for them to cherish and yet again to set the momentum. Are you in the list?
So now you know what all these individuals had to go through, but I meet a lot of people throughout the year, and whether those candidates really make it to the final list or they don't, I think the common thread and the common feedback that everybody who participates in this process, and you've seen the level of detail that this process goes through, everybody defines this as a wonderful journey of introspection, an opportunity for them to really check where they are and what they're doing, benchmark themselves, and also probably reflect back on what else can they do. So I think as a process is not only the final stage, which some of you will make it to the list of 2016, but it's also the journey of so many individuals who are really ambitious and they want to make a difference by leveraging the power of their profession. So I think we're ready. Yeah. Anu, any closing thoughts? Because we really need to get started.
Absolutely.
Now.
Absolutely. I'll be the devil in this piece if I were to say any more than what has been
said. Let's give a big round of applause to all our finalists before
Thank
we
you.
Start.
Thank you.
Thank you once again, Esther and Anu. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so here we are. The moment that we all have been waiting for is right here. So are we ready to reveal the list that we have all been waiting for? Are we all ready?
Yes.
Okay, I don't think everybody is. So are we all ready?
Yes.
Fantastic. So I'm sure the anxiety is actually building in, and we shall start with the first set of awards right away. Please note there is no order or ranking to the names that will be called. They are in random order that will be called by the jury. This year we have a special gift for our winners, courtesy Gift XOXO, our rewards and recognition partner. Let's kickstart our first set of awards with your due consent, everybody. I'd like to invite, we'll go set by set. So for our first set of jury members, I'd like to invite our jury members, S. Varadarajan, Tata SIA, and Meenal Jadhav, Schneider Electric, to come up on the stage and please give away the first set of the awards. Over to both of you. Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Look, any reward and recognition program will be successful only based on the enthusiasm of the participants as well as the audience. So I don't see that enthusiasm as yet. Good evening.
Good evening.
I have a mic. I can be without a mic and I'm still louder. Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you. That's better. You know, it's wonderful to be here. Fifth year in a row, and I have been telling Esther I'm due for gratuity now. It's been a wonderful journey for us, and personally, I would say that I have learned so much. I'm unashamed to say that I have learned a lot over the 5 years, and in a selfish way, I keep coming back to be a jury member. You know, some of the things which I've learned in the last 5 years, the passion which I have learned from the participants, the amount of passion they bring into the entire event, the lateral thinking which I see in the participants, youngsters with the lateral thinking, you make you wonder whether we were so lateral when we were young, which is very long ago, and also learning from analytics, analyzing everything which they do before they come to a conclusion. You know, HR is no longer the soft, oozy thing which you say, okay, you can't measure. I think a lot of learning over the 5 years, personally for me, and I thank each and every participant for that. Thank you so much for that. And while we continue with the award ceremony, one thing I'm going to make sure is that there's a big round of applause for every person who gets it, right from number one to the last one who gets the award. Let's practice an applause now. Can we? Come on, go. It has to come from your heart and also physical like me. And also shouting and giving your appreciation is also welcome.
Raja, you said it all, and I can sense a lot of simmering anticipation in the room, so I'm not really going to hold the the award declaration too far, but just one thing I want to share is that one of the common threads, this is the third year that I've been on the jury, and one of the common threads that I see over these years is that each one of you who's here has shown a lot of belief in your values and a lot of courage to speak up, and I hope as an HR community you will continue to carry that as you move into your future career. So over to you, Raja, to declare the first one.
Okay. A very inquisitive learner, passionate sports person, and a happy worker. He wants HR to mandate data, both quantitative and qualitative, as the cornerstone of every decision and every recommendation. A BITS Pilani graduate, armed with an MBA from XLRI Jamshedpur, this young man's HR agenda for 2017 is designed for the population and keep getting better at it. And the award goes to, I don't know why Akanksha doesn't want to change this. I have to pause and give a big smile, and then announce the winner. The winner is Abhishek Buddhiraja, Associate Director HR Talent Management, OD and OE from Snapdeal.
Gratifying experience, and thank you so much. Sir, ma'am, both were in my interview as well, so thank you. Special thank yous to you as well.
I have nothing.
Absolutely. I learned so much during the process, and it was extremely exhausting at times, but thank you, People Matters, for having a really genuine process, which everybody, I'm sure, felt really good being a part of the process itself. So thank you. Thanks again.
What is one thing you're going to do differently when you get back to work tomorrow?
There is a DDI workshop, so I'm not getting back to work tomorrow.
Okay, so here goes the next awardee. Having done his postgraduate in human resources from MDI Gurgaon, he joined SR Group as a management trainee. With more than 7 years of rich HR experience across varied roles, he strongly believes in making HR function relevant to the business and driving HR initiatives which would add value to the business. He describes HR as indispensable, and his hobby include reading biographies of renowned leaders and sportspersons and playing cricket. Let's hear it for Salil Raheja, Deputy General Manager, SR Steel.
It's really a privilege to be a part of the list. I've been actually trying for this RU in the list for past 2 years. So this is my second attempt. Yeah. So boosts one's self-confidence, and I think I'll be now more passionate within my role and in the HR function where I will work.
Thank you. creative, curious, and a writer. This lady, apart from being an HR professional, is also an HR blogger. She loves to pen down anything and everything about HR. She believes that HR is still the most underestimated profession of all time. Thank you. Yet she is, in her own words, obsessed with all things HR, Amazon, and behavioral economics. Let's hear it for Ankita Poddar, HR business partner, Amazon.
Speaking here, but yes, I would prefer that, and I will write about the entire journey. So if you're interested, I mean, shameless promotion of the blog. But I think it's been great. I've learned something at every stage, and this is great validation, and I know it helps take my work to the industry a lot more easily. So thank you.
Next blog be on?
Nothing in HR.
Oh, I only write about HR.
If you are given an opportunity to write anything outside HR?
I wanted to write about psychology a lot. Not about HR, but long time ago I wanted to write a book, and that was about how psychiatrists play with their patients. But yeah.
Wow. All the best.
Raja and Meenal, everybody. Thank you so much, Raja and Meenal. So congratulations to the first set of awardees. Can we hear it for the three fantastic, fantastic winners? Thank you. Thank you so much. So our evening is just incomplete without the presence of our past finalists and winners, right? So we have a couple of our backbenchers right here. I can see a couple of them. So may I try and spot one of you? They have actually they've actually nurtured a lot of them across various forums, across various platforms of People Matters programs. So they have really been a very critical part of all of us. I can actually spot Ashish right here, Ashish Kapoor. Can we have the catch box for Ashish, please?
Can you catch that?
Ashish, over to you with the catch box. Brilliant. So what we have a question for you, Ashish, your journey, an anecdote from Are You in the List that you would like to share with all of us, because you have been a winner for many years now. So
years,
how do you like
yes.
to share? What would you say?
Do I get something to speak? Oh, okay.
That's the mic.
This is the mic.
I didn't realize. I was just thinking, yeah. That is what I thought.
That's the mic.
You know, because when we had, our time, there was no gifts, and you just announced XXXOXO wasn't a partner then, but, so it was fun, of course. The journey itself was, of course, fun, but I think for all the winners who get this award today, I think I'll only like to add that the journey after you get the award is equally fun. And, you know, we have this group of, I don't know, around 80, 90 odd people. You can imagine how close we are. You're all sitting here together, most of us. And the amount of detailed information, the amount of what's happening in day-to-day world, that sort of information is shared so much that you know, you're just boggled at times with, you know, how much can you absorb. But it's wonderful to be part of it.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ashish. That's Ashish for us. Thank you. Now, I'm going to come back with that catch box. That catch box is equal to a mic. So I'm going to come back with that. With that, let's dive into our second set of our awards. So to continue with this excitement, we have three jury members for the second set. So may I request Mr. Dwarkanath, Max India, Shalini Pillai, KPMG, and Anuranjita Kumar from City, South Asia, to please come up on the stage. Let's hear it for them. Over to you.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank People Matters for actually being so forward-looking and forward-thinking in terms of creating the award that they have. I think it's a brilliant platform, not just for all of you, but for all of us who are probably belong to a different generation. But I think it has given us an opportunity to interact with our own future. And future is you, and future is bright, which I think for me personally is a very optimistic thought and a feeling. So thank you for the opportunity. I think it's been a pleasure and a privilege to interact with the participants, not only this year, but even the previous years. And like Raja was saying, every interaction is a learning for us, and we grow and evolve. So with that, I'll announce the first awardee amongst the three of us. Wow, so this is Chocolate Company, an engineer from NIT Bhopal, an MBA from XLRI. She has worked with Cadbury's, now of course Mondelez, in Mumbai, Singapore and Delhi. Her varied work locations have inspired her to travel and experience the new cultures. Her biggest personal achievement has been to travel to the Arctic Circle. Well, I do need to have this offline conversation with you. And back on a solo backpacking trip. She's optimistic, easygoing, and straightforward person, and describes HR professionals as charismatic. So let's give a round of applause to Neeti Goyal.
Extremely privileged, grateful, thankful, and of course very happy to be here tonight. My father is here, my dear friend Neha is here, so very happy to have them here watching this moment. Thank you to the People Matters team, to the DDI team, to all the jury members. It was an absolute pleasure as well as a learning journey throughout the RU in the List Awards. We'll cherish this moment for times to come. And thank you again. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to just say my two bits too, besides adding and echoing everything that Anu and several others have said. I think it's been a fantastic journey for us as well, an absolutely privileged learning experience. And the one thing, as I look at where the future workforce is headed, I think it is going to be in good hands. With these rising stars steering the people agenda into the future, it certainly looks more than bright. To announce our next winner, genuine, simple, inquisitive, describe her the best. Armed with masters in management studies, her foray into HR was inspired by her own grandfather, whom she gives credit for her HR acumen. She describes HR as a catalyst and describes her Are You in the List journey as a very intellectually stimulating and people-binding journey of self-discovery. Let's put our hands together for Apoorva Pradhan, Assistant Manager, TCS.
Hello.
evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And it is so nice to be part of this evening today. Thank you all for making it here, because your presence has made not only this evening, but the entire award, entire process more rewarding and more meaningful. I'm sorry, but I'm going to take a couple of your minutes. I've practiced this speech so many times. You know, I was doing these positive affirmations. I'm going to win. So as a part of that, you know, I practiced this. So a couple of minutes, please excuse. So first of all, I would like to thank my parents who are here tonight and very enthusiastically taking my photos and all of that. So they are the ones who have taught me everything about being a human that is actually important for our function. They're the ones who have taught me to take my first steps. They're the ones who have taught me to laugh, cry, forgive, love, everything, which I believe is very important as a part of our profession. And they have sown the seeds, the fruits of which I'm reaping today. And as they say that you can't just plant a tree and forget about it. You have to water it. You have to nurture it. So that bit of support function mechanism has been done by my supervisors, who have very, very ably guided me throughout not just this process, but right from the beginning of my career. I would like to state the name of Shalini Gupta and Rajit here. And of course, my very supportive husband, Sneh. And there are so many people who really wanted me to win. They have always been so supportive throughout the entire process. So I somehow feel that this award is more deserving for them than me. I'm just a representative here, but this is actually a win for so many others that I really can't name so many people right now, but this one goes out to all of you. And lastly, I would like to thank People Matters, DDI, and all the jury members, because your task was not at all easy. It's still possible to judge performance, but to judge potential is not easy. So hats off to you guys. Great job done there. And with that, I would like to end my 15 or other 5 minutes of fame. Thank you so much for very patiently listening to me, and a happy new year to all of you for that.
I need to bend. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want to repeat what has been said, but let me try do it differently. Okay. Every year, Esther, and now my esteemed colleague, Anu Oman, whom we work together, try to innovate something so that they can eliminate me from the next year jury. Okay, and Akhil also joins in the same band as me. So they create some award. Lifetime Achievement Award or Long Service Awards is not gratuity, Raja. Long Service Award, or you say this is end of it when you are retiring. Let me tell you, Akhil and me will not retire. Okay, there is nothing like retirement in life. I think, you know, what I just want to say, especially the message to youngsters, I need to congratulate all of them for having come through seamlessly to this level. I think it's a lot of efforts required. It's a very rigorous process, which has been said. Hats off to you guys, kudos. But this is only a step towards your long journey. And people are saying that you will become the great future HR leaders. I would say future leaders of this country. I think, you know, it's not just HR, future leaders of the country. I think one of the most important aspects, if you want to really succeed, is to have the passion. If you have passion, age is a mindset. I'm not saying because I'm aged, but I'm saying you can, at a young age, you can be disconnected. But think, don't success go to your head? At the same time, this is the step towards, if you show that passion, you can continue to show that passion, especially if you want to succeed in HR. I think what is the most important thing, high levels of energy and passion, the commitment is required. If you do that, everything is well. So let me assure you to my dear colleague Anu and Esther, I am not retiring. You may invite me as a jury or not, I am not retiring. So it's important that while doing this, you can do many things. Today I'm really honored, because it's not only been invited by Esther and Anu to join here from DDI and People's Matters. For a change, I'm in a minority today. Okay, it's a pleasant place to be in minority, okay? So I think it's very important, please, to see the, when they were saying who will start it, They said, you are in minority, you start it. Okay, it's a great thing to have. There is a diversity in terms of the awards. I see many youngsters coming. It's not the just the male and female, but in the kind of variety you see it here, not from one institute, it's not just the premier institutes, from a different institutes, different sectors of business. So I think this award has gone into a different dimensions. What is being conceived 5 years back and what is today is something very different. And this is a message the award winners should carry forward and carry to the others, saying this is something which you really should earn. This is not to get a job. It is not just to make a career, but it gives a sort of a motivation, what I call psychic income, which can take you to different levels to achieve many more milestones, and this can be seen as a stepping stone. Sorry for my long speech, but I think, you know, I wish all the winners and those who could not succeed today, don't give it up. Please continue, try. If not this one, you can achieve something bigger, but try to focus on it. There are four kinds of people. People who watch things happening, people who do not know what's happening, people to whom things happen. But distinguished minority are those who make things happen. I wish you are one of them. Thank you. Now I have a very pleasant job to perform. The winner of this award, with a personal philosophy of make it matter, this emerging HR leader strives for excellence in whatever she does. In MBA in HR, she believes that HR in today's world is an institution in itself that can help business to transform its core differentiator, which is people. Her HR agenda for 2017 is to create a workplace as an experience. Spending quality time with her family helps her unwind and get back to work with regenerated vigor. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Megha Gupta. Ask a question or you have a prepared talk? I mean, you can be very transparent, no issues. You prepared something you want to say?
I'm okay with both.
Okay. Tell me, who is your favorite cricketer? Don't say Virat Kohli.
Okay. Actually, no one. I hardly watch cricket.
Okay, say what you like.
My husband keeps watching cricket and I always sleep. I think the only thing right now comes to my mind is, yay, I made it. The only thing that, you know, comes to my mind right now, I still remember the day when I got an email from People Matters and it talked about, are you in the list? And I was looking at all the last year winners and I was thinking to myself, can I be part of that list? And here I am, being part of the list. I think, thank you so much, People Matters. Thank you, DDI. Thank you, Manisha. I think she's been a great partner from People Matters. Thank you, my entire team, my colleagues, my ex-bosses. They're all here just for me. Thank you, Rahul, my husband, who's, I don't know about my sleepless night, but I definitely had many nights sleepless for him, pestering him. Will I clear this round? But thank you. I just want to share a quick, small story. There was a small boy who was looking out of his window. It was raining very heavily, and he was very sad. So his mom looked into him, and he said, why are you so sad? And he just said that, I want to go out and play. So the mom looked at him and said, so why don't you go out and play if you really want to do that? And he said, hey, mom, it's raining. How do you expect me to go out? So the mom just went inside and got an umbrella. And the boy said, mom, is it going to stop raining if I just use an umbrella? The mom looked into his eyes and just said, no, it's not going to stop the rain, but it's going to give you the confidence to walk in the rain. I think winning this is definitely the same confidence that gives me to believe that, yes, I'm doing something right and I want to continue in that journey. It's that confidence that makes me believe in my own self. It's the confidence that makes me believe that hard work and dedication can take me many, many miles and help me achieve all my milestones. And it's that confidence that makes me proudly say today, yes, I'm part of the list. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Mr. Dwarkanath, Shalini and Anu. Thank you so much. Let's hear it once again for the second set of the winners, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations. Congratulations to each one of you. Okay. Now that most of our past winners are backbenchers, and like Ashish said, they're all sitting together, I can spot Sumit Nyogi. Sumit, catch box for you. Could you share a journey, an incident that you think that you really look back to when you talk about Are You in the List?
Yeah. So actually, it was on the award night. I remember Saurav Nigam was with me. So both of us, obviously, it was alphabetical on that day. And when 21 awards were given, we thought, you know, it's better to have a drink now and move out. And when my name was announced, I was outside. So that definitely I remember. On a separate note, I agree with what Ashish said. For me, it's obviously it's now 5 years. I was part of the first list when I was there, and I actually see some of the profiles very similar, which are coming up on the board. It gives you the responsibility. People look up to you after once you know you are a part of it, and the journey has really evolved. And every batch which has been added from the second, third, fourth list. It has increased the credibility of the awards, and it has been great last 5 years. I have to be honest. Every time, whenever I've mentioned I was part of the first list, it has brought smiles on the face of the person who has been speaking to me. So I would rather share it has enhanced my credibility in the last 5 years.
Fantastic! Thank you so much, Sumit. Let's hear it for Sumit, ladies and gentlemen. So just to resonate what Sumit said, that definitely this is not a destination, but a journey. So, you know, moving on. So we are just beginning with the celebrations. All right. Just let me remind you some more energy, because we are going to still have to clap for the other winners. All right. So we are going to now step into our third set. For the third set, I'd like to call upon Prabhakar from ITC. Kamlesh Dangi from UTI Mutual Fund, and Srivats Jaipuria from Jaipuria Institute of Management to give away the next set of awards. Let's hear it for them, ladies and gentlemen. Over to you.
Good evening, everybody. I have been lucky to sort of been part of this journey for the last 5 years. As Raja said, I think I have also earned the right for gratuity. And every year it's been a different experience. And I was just reflecting in terms of what does being part of the jury of Are You in the List mean to me, at least. It's there all in the name, Are You in the List. If you really look at this 5 or 6 common parameters, all the winners across the 5 batches, they're aspiring, youthful in their thinking, actions, not linked to age. Inspiring, they're very tenacious. In fact, what we noticed was the people who have been able to make it have demonstrated tenacity, and they are learners, continuous learners. That's what makes this entire breed of people in Are You in the List very, very different. On a lighter note, last year I think I had mentioned it to Esther offline. We said maybe you'll have to start 2 different categories. Could you have been in the list? For people like us who never had the opportunity to participate. Or, are you in the list for all people who are 50 years and above? Sorry, both of you will not qualify. And we will still have Dwarka and Akhil in the jury for that also. without waiting sort of for the next award, All of you must be saying, ye dil mange more. And you will realize why I am saying, ye dil mange more. Her three-year-old daughter is her biggest strength. This gentle lady, who has 8.5 years of experience, started with PepsiCo as a management trainee. And since then, has been donning multiple hats across HR, managing diverse workforce with different backgrounds, generations, cultures, and raising and customizing HR delivery to keep this diverse workforce engaged is what keeps her awake at night. When she's not working, she loves to travel. And as Raja said, this is something which has not changed for the last 5 years. The award goes to POS and Ye Dil Mange More, Shweta Arya. Senior Manager, Talent Acquisition, PepsiCo.
Everyone, I haven't prepared at all, and I am a professional who doesn't want to create anything new, so I'll just do a control X and control V of everything that has been said. And additionally, I just want to thank all the people who've come down specially to support me, starting from people who are not even there, my bosses, mentors, and everyone that I've worked with who's helped me grow further, and my current boss Pavitra, who's a delight to work with. I really appreciate that you came down all the way. My husband, my daughter, my best buddy, Stuti, everyone, thank you so much. Paki, I love you.
Okay, good evening, everyone. As most of the juries are saying, I mean, I don't want to repeat, it's obviously has been a great learning experience for juries as well. It's been a pleasure to be associated for a number of years. But I just wanted to highlight one more piece. I think any award becomes big, and obviously this award is possibly getting into a different league now with so many, 2,500 plus in this year itself. But I think if you look back in 5 years, I think this award has become big because of those 10,000 people who have kind of applied for this award, right? So I think somewhere I was listening to Mr. Mariwala, he spoke about two things. One is a growth mindset and a learning orientation. And I think all these 10,000 people are exemplifying that piece of they were growth mindset and they had a learning orientation, and that's how they applied for it. So I think we should just have one round of applause for all of them. Okay, let me read more about the next winner. An engineering graduate, that is computer science with PG in management from VGSOM IIT Kharagpur. This man started his job at Infosys as an HR functional consultant and now has been with the organization for 11 plus years. He invests his free time in everything which life has to offer, from movie making to pet psychology and everything that interests him. As again, a pause, Ravi Bajpai, practice at Talent Acquisition Infosys.
People would call as accidental HR. So I didn't start it out in HR field, and somehow I ended up here. In fact, one of the questions which Prabhakar sir had for me was, what are you doing in HR? So I guess this justifies that all those movies which you saw in Hollywood about the late bloomers, Rocky Balboa. They are real. So thank you, and I would like to thank everyone, all my, to start with my team, who inspired me and taught me every day what it takes to be a good HR, and the people who are my supervisors, my boss, who are patient enough whenever I committed a mistake, they patiently said, okay, happens, chalta hai. And of course, the people who were part of the evaluation process who guided me as well, and the whole journey has been very educating, very enlightening. And thank you guys. Have a nice evening. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Congratulations. We've been associated with Are You in the List from Jaipuria Institute of Management since its very inception, which was almost 5 years ago, and have seen how these awards have gained prestige within the community. And I, just as I was attending and listening to everybody talk this evening, I felt that a lot of credit goes to the team at People Matters, because the awards and the way that it is run is sort of become a microcosm of a lot of the values that you talk about. You've seen them talking about the changes that they're bringing, how they're adapting themselves every year, as well as growing in terms of reach and quality. But at the same time, when you look at some of the people who've spoken before me, whether it's the jury members, the sponsors, even some of the awardees who've participated in multiple years, they've been able to retain the same people, the same sort of passion. And I think this is really, a lot of credit goes to them for being able to do this and grow at the same time in terms of quality and reach every year. So as a group that trains the next generation of young managers, it was always a very natural partnership for us to partner with this sort of awards. And really, it is my proud privilege to be presenting the next award today. So, music, reading, sports, debates. The young man dabbles in all of these with elan. His love for music made him to learn multiple instruments, including guitar. He is also a part of a rock band and has done multiple shows. The MBA grad from Symbiosis Center for Management and Human Resource Development is usually inspired by Dr. T.V. Rao. His HR agenda for 2017 is to pursue certification in psychometric tools and try to be involved in various HR projects that have wider impact on the organization. And the award goes to, you know who you are, Shreyas Haridas, HR Business Partner, Star India Private Limited.
Hi, good evening, everyone. I must admit, I had actually started counting the number of people who've already got the reward till now. Anyway, I think it's a privilege to be standing here. It's an absolute honor to be standing here in front of such an august crowd. I've actually known people from at least one person from each of the previous four batches, so this was a really aspirational award for me, and I'm truly happy that I'm a part of the list this year. My congratulations to all the other winners from this year, and thank you to People Matters and DDI. This has honestly been a very, very enriching experience through and through. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Prabhakar, Kamlesh, and Srivas. Thank you very much. Thank you. Let's hear it for the jury and also the third set of the finalists. Okay, let me tell you, we need to have some more energy. So can we hear it once again? Fantastic. So, we have our catch box just coming in on the way. Now, they are really, really good friends, huh? Now, they're all sitting in one place. Oh, we have we have a few. Yeah, because I could just spot everybody there. Fantastic. But I just seen Anunay. Right? Anunay. Yes. Anunay. How do you feel? And anything to share? We had a Star India winner already.
Well, I think just 2 minutes back, I heard the soundtrack of Jurassic Park. And I was wondering why Jurassic Park. I think typically our jobs, by the end of the day, we are mostly in the shape of Rocky Balboas. I think both Ashish as well as Sumit spoke about the group, the crazy group that we have. And just a couple of days back, we were talking about psychometric assessments in that group. And one of our colleagues did mention, Girish, sorry, but I'm using it. How does it matter if on a holiday I don't want to see a museum? How does it decide my personality? And the reactions were a smiley, a LOL. So a group of people, 60, 70 of us, who don't judge any of us, at the same time, you have a repository of information available to you and solution at the flick of a thumb. That's what this journey for me personally has been the biggest advantage that I have. Obviously, a couple of promotions and double salary has always helped. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Anunay. That's Anunay for you. So, do we continue to have the energy for the next set of awards? No, not enough. Do we continue to have energy for the next set of awards? Yes. Fantastic. So we are just now going to step into, it's just that group, right? We're just stepping into the fourth set of award. Continuing with the excitement, I'd like to call upon Dr. Akhil Bustrai from Akhil Bustrai Consulting and Sachin Agrawal from AMS Inform. Let's welcome them with a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Over to you.
Good evening. You know, if I say this is the fifth year, it will be repeating what my other colleagues have mentioned. But the significant part is two things that I want to share. One, the profile of participants and the way they get selected and the way things have improved. And there's one question I've asked in jury very often, that how many women in the list that we are looking at? This is an important question to ask, because today if we look at diversity and we look at the representation of from gender angle, it is very important that we recognize in fair manner both the genders. And I'm very glad that the process that People Matters and DDI have adopted brings out the very best amongst the good people. Now, let me give you a peep into the interview process. And Yuvraj, you are there. I can see you. And he and Raja will possibly bear out. Sometimes they would ask after the interview is over, why were you so tough on this candidate in asking and grilling? And I think it's a fair question, but the reason was that the selection process that we have had the privilege to sit through as a member of jury gives an onus and a responsibility to so many good people to select the very best. So I want to talk about the process and the robustness of this process and the quality of people that come through and the learning that we get, refreshing, rejuvenating. Some of the candidates who appear are mavericks. Fortunately, some of them are deep thinkers. It takes all kinds. So it has been a real privilege to be part of the jury. And for the first awardee, if I can read the citation, Raja, it also says in my card, smile and pause and smile later on, but not in the beginning. Very serious. So passionate about backpacking and traveling, this chief people officer keeps on learning fresh perspective about life from his travel journeys. Armed with a degree in MBA HR from SIBM Pune, he would love HR to stop being a paper pusher and focus more on HR analytics and technology orientation of HR. he describes Are You in the List journey as very intriguing, thought-provoking, and exciting, and rightly so. So ladies and gentlemen, please join me in honoring Aditya Adyar.
Hi everyone, good evening. Yeah, so for more than anyone else, for me it's really important because I've seen that most of you are from MNCs and have varied experiences. So I am from a tech startup, Fasos, and after 4 years of working with ICICI Bank, then I took up the mantle of handling HR for Fasos, and it was a 1,000 employee organization, and now it's 2,500 plus across 10 cities. So maybe I actually didn't know whether I'm doing things right or wrong, or whether I'm headed in the right direction or not. But standing here after all these grueling rounds of interviews, now I know that I'm doing something right. Thanks.
Good evening, everyone. My company, AMS, has been a partner with People Matters for the second consecutive year for doing background checks on all the nominated participants here. And it's been a pleasure. So thank you, People Matters, for making us part of this. Before I call out this card, I'd like to share an interesting quote which I came across by a person called Ken Robinson. And I think this pretty much sums up the entire evening as why we are having this award. Human resources are like natural resources. They are often buried deep. You have to go looking for them. They are not just lying around on the surface. You have to create the circumstances where they show themselves. I think this is a very specific reason why we are here, to recognize all these HR professionals in the industry today. And so congratulations to all those who have been nominated today. And good luck to all those who are going to get award today. So the next card that I'm going to call out. This business management postgraduate from XLRI Jamshedpur has gained multiple credentials in HR, namely chartered MCIPD from CIPD UK, SPHR, and HRMP from SHRM, HRCI. He describes HR as a continuum between employee advocacy and strategic skills. His varied interests include volunteering for social causes, and his free time he enjoys reading spiritual books, singing, traveling, and food. He describes Are You in the List journey as one where the process helped him to reinforce his strengths and also highlight development areas where he can improve further as an HR professional. So let's hear for it. Siddharth Bhasin from Google.
Wow. I'd like to thank God, my parents, all the mentors and coaches who have helped me reach where I am today. A business management graduate, proudly in HR. And I think when I say this for all the participants and winners, we would continue doing the work and ensure that, you know, as an HR fraternity, all of us have reasons to be proud of each other. Thank you.
Don't go. Were you surprised?
Pleasantly, yes.
What surprised you?
for finally getting it. I think that that's was a surprise for me, but yeah, I'm happy.
Our next winner, an MA in Personnel Management from Tata Institute of Social Sciences. She is a canine behaviorist and founder of the Human-Dog Interaction Project. Her extraordinary projects include integrating dogs into the solution for various talent management processes like employee wellness, experiential learning, CSR activities, and a fun at work. She describes HR as a function in constant transition. Please join me in honoring Rajeshwari Ramachandran.
Said to myself, there is one thing I don't want in my life, and that is regret. So last year, I quit my job of 11 years with a company that I joined from campus. To bring my passion for dogs and human resources together, I founded the Human-Dog Interaction Project. I am now on a mission to spread empathy in organizations through dogs. And when I met Prabhakar and Shalini, they asked me why this award this year, and I told them, you know what, I'll be 35 next year. Which means if I don't participate this year, I'm going to regret forever that I did not participate in this, you know, awards. And that's how, and I'm very happy that I'm a part of this award. I saw a lot of young people win this award. I feel privileged to be a part of you. And yeah, I have a big thank you list. I have to thank my parents. I have to thank my husband, Ashish, who always puts up with all my idiosyncrasies. I have to thank my dogs, Calvin, Hobbs, and Susie, who keep me sane. And yeah, I have five other people to thank. I have to thank Namita, Supriti, Bharti, Abhijit Bhadri, and Saurabh Govil. All five have more ambition for me than I have ever had for myself. So thank you so much for this opportunity.
You know, Rajeshwari, hearing you, I'm not being formal, but hearing you is inspiring. If you have a conviction, the type that you display, we have a lot to learn from you. So very grateful for the type of comments that you share and the passion that you show. It's very humbling to be on the same platform with you. Thank you, ma'am.
Just one second. And that was a marketing pitch. You can actually invite Human Dog Interaction Project into your organizations, by the way.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Busra and Sachin. Thank you so much. Let's hear it for Dr. Busra and Sachin, ladies and gentlemen. May I request you all to give a big round of applause to the fourth set of category. Thank you. Before we actually step into the fifth set of the category, I can spot Imran right here. Imran Ali, yes, hi. So we have a catchbox mic right here for you. Okay. So Imran, any anecdote, anything you'd like to share about Are You in the List journey and your journey after that?
I think the entire process was a journey into myself. Mm-hmm. I think that's, you know, the first milestone for for self awareness. And I said this last year as well. I feel very privileged to be part of this 80 member group. And a lot has been spoken about the WhatsApp group where, you know, all the 80 of us come together. And I would share one anecdote which probably summarizes, you know, what happens on that WhatsApp group. Somebody said this WhatsApp group is the consultant's lifeline. So I think that pretty much summarizes, you know, the amount of intellectual horsepower that can coexist in one WhatsApp group. So I'm highly privileged to be part of this group. And congratulations to all the winners and their families, and to People Matters and DDI for creating, something. I call RU in the List an institute in itself, and I'm a proud alumni of this institute.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Imranali. Thank you. Thank you so much. To the institute. Thank you. Moving on to the final set of awards. Now we have to still keep some energy going, all right? So to moving on to the final set of awards, may I invite on stage Yuvraj Srivastava, MakeMyTrip.com, Jacob Jacob from Apollo Hospitals, and Nitin Mehta from Manjin to please join us on the stage. Let's hear it for them, ladies and gentlemen. Louder. Over to you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Coming last after eloquent and articulate people like Akhil, Raja, Dwarka, the disadvantage is all through the session, they've been asking me what are you going to talk, and whatever I told them, I think that they all spoke that, right? So I have nothing really to say. And this process continued earlier also during the selection rounds. And all those guys who have won the award, they should, be really, really obliged to me because I got these guys to hold on from asking questions on Section 5B of Industrial Disputes Act, Factories Act, how will you retrench, how will you calculate gratuity. I said, let it be. I think that gone are the days when we used to live with these type of realities. I think nowadays HR is different. And that's what really showcased in the whole process. My learning and experience in the last 3 years had been great, and I think that everything has been spoken about that. Important is really talk a couple of things which I realized as a differentiator for people who won the award and people who still could not really make it. And that was very clearly in a very grassroots language, I'll say that how a person can really cut the faff from the reality and the impact of what a person has done. A lot of time what happens, you have 3 years, 4 years of experience, but you try to project something which is far, far bigger than that. I think how a person can contain oneself to be what a person is, how can a person really narrate the experiences or the impact one has created at the role what was being done by a person, comes out very, very clearly, genuinely in terms of the conversation and answers. Answers which really, really surprised us and also created huge amount of impact was, in case somebody could talk about, as an HR professional, how could really identify a business problem and go and do something maybe with a marketing function or the sales function, help them transform their function or work with them to create impact, and also could understand the intricacies of business. Though it is a very cliched way of talking that HR should be very, very close to business, but when HR professionals talk about business, it comes out very clearly that have they really been a part of the business delivery or they are talking something which they have heard in the galleries and the corridors. I think that's something which clearly differentiated people. Also important was that, passion, energy, everything has been spoken about. It was also very important to see that everybody does engagement in a role. Everybody does hiring in a role. Everybody does a lot of things which are rigmarole of HR, what we call it. How you really take your work to a very different level of innovative ways of thinking. How have you created things which are different than what had been existing in the organization? And if somebody talks about it passionately and also measures the impact, I think jury members like Raja, Akhil, Dwarkanath, and Jacob, I think they somewhere get pretty impressed about that. And my role had been only to observe them. In the process, I have learned. In the process, I have also gained a lot of experience in terms of how to differentiate wheat from the chaff and good talent from not so good talent. All the best to all the guys who have won, and all the best to people who have been a part of the alumni or who continue to be part of the alumni list to go and create impact in this very, very changing, differentiated world what we have right now, and huge amount of opportunities for the HR professionals to create impact in the business with everything happening around in the macro economy. All the best to everyone, and my role now is to really read about a citation. She did her BA honors in psychology before pursuing her management. Her proficiency lies in managing HR administrative activities as well as design and development of HR systems based on behavioral science. Her biggest strength is her ability to cope with stress. While she loves reading her free time, she believes that HR should continue to maintain a balance between people welfare and business orientation. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause for Soumya Malkani. Thank you. Soumya is Deputy Manager, Organization Development, Tata AIA General Insurance Company. Congratulations, Soumya.
Everybody, good evening. This is a little incredible for me, but I must say that the last few months and this journey has been one of the most enriching and the most delightful experiences of my life. And I feel so honored and privileged and humbled to be part of this list along with some amazingly talented people. And this is really one of the most wonderful experiences of my life. So I'd like to thank everybody. I'd like to thank the team of People Matters and DDI. I'd like to thank all members of my family who've been a perpetual support system, and all my professional colleagues, managers, and mentors whom I've worked with. Thank you, everybody.
Are we the last man standing between you guys and cocktails? So I will keep it very short. Well, to start with, it feels great to be here. This is my first time at RUA The List. And we as Monjans, and one, me as a promoter of Monjan, the video assessment partner for RUA in The List, are proud to be part of the whole team. And we sincerely thank People Matters and DDI to help us through this process and also take our assistance in the entire evaluation for the future HR leaders. Our journey began about August of this year, and we are hoping that we continue this journey and make sure that next year we reduce the burden on juries to make it a very, very simple process. Let me go back to my task of announcing the next award. She is an engineering graduate with an MBA in human resources who started her professional career with sales as a launchpad. In her words, she is a maximizer, someone who tries to stimulate personal and group excellence through her strengths. A go-getter, and with heavy bias for action, she loves to indulge her free time in badminton, palmistry, and trekking. She describes HR as a delightful evolving function, which has taken a quantum leap in the last two decades to help businesses stay afloat in today's VUCA world. Ladies and gentlemen, please have a big round of applause for Apeksha Jain, Senior HR Business Partner, PepsiCo.
Moment of privilege, and I'm really honored to get this award. It feels great to get this award, but I think what was more great was the entire journey. It was a very enriching and exciting journey. At every stage, as every stage evolved, I think the kind of self-discovery that was bestowed upon me, I think that was the best thing I felt about this entire process. I would just like to take a moment. So I'm actually not able to digest that, okay, I've got this award. I'd just like to take a moment and thank my parents, my family, my husband, all my mentors and my gurus for their support and guidance throughout. Thank you so much again.
Good evening, everyone.
You know, Yuvraj, pairing us continuously year on year must be by design with some ulterior motive. See, I was really looking forward to coming for this event, but I'm sure all of you would have read what's been happening in Tamil Nadu and with Apollo. First, I thought I would get beaten up by the public. Then I thought I'd be blown away by the cyclone. Thankfully, both have not happened, and you know, thankfully, I've been able to get to Delhi here. On a serious note, I think you know one of the biggest things which IU in the list has given to the HR fraternity is the fact that HR as a reference point is more being used in the Indian context. So if you look at the last 3 to 4 years, lot many surveys, lot many contextual references of HR has been with Indian companies. I think that credit goes to the youngsters who made it to the IU on the list. So big kudos to all of you for doing that. Well, the next winner is, her husband is her biggest strength. She's an alumnus of Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai, and Lady Shriram College, Delhi. She enjoys designing personalized gifts for her family and friends. Further, she has keen interest in writing and would like to pursue that someday. In her words, HR is the custodian of policies, processes, and culture for the organization. Let's hear it for Snigdha Singh Chowdhury, Senior Manager, Cipla.
Good evening, everyone. So it's very different actually up here. Seeing everyone from that side is actually a different experience. Yes, we've been waiting for this moment, extremely positive like the other participants. I think that is one thing that we were also looking for in the people who actually make it to the list. As stated, my family, friends, colleagues, almost for everyone, that's been the biggest strength, and it continues to be for me as well. I'll just share a small story. When I entered TIS and it was 3 months in the system, I was actually not able to understand what does HR do and what is it that I'll be expected to do once I get out in my career. So it became so overwhelming that at one point I thought, this is not what I want to do. And let me just get out of this college. And that's when my husband, my classmate, actually helped me and took me through the entire journey. And standing here today and being honored for knowing HR slightly better than a lot of other people is extremely humbling as an experience. Thank you so much, and thank you to everyone who's made this happen. It's a long list. If I start taking names, I will certainly be beaten by someone who I don't name. So thank you so much, and we look forward to being part of the great alumni group that I can see sitting behind. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Let's hear it for our last jury set of pair. Sorry, last pair of jury. Thank you. Thank you so much. Shall we put our hands together for a fantastic evening? All the winners, all our jury members, all everybody who's made it possible. So let's put our hands together for everyone, ladies and gentlemen. This evening has indeed been very eventful. So with this, we actually are stepping towards the closure of the awards ceremony. But I must say that the journey of Are You in the List 2016 is incomplete or is not possible without our partners and the support of our partners. I'd like to thank each one of them. Our process partner, DDI, Are You in the List is powered by Cornerstone On Demand. Let's keep hearing it for them, ladies and gentlemen. B-School partner, Jaipuria Institute of Management. Background verification partner, AMS Inform. I know it's long, but I'll carry on. Video assessment partner, Monjin. Associate partner, Mansa Consulting. Talent transformation partner, Edge Networks. Organizational development partner, C2C OD. Associate partner, Potentia Life. Certification partner, SIMA. Rewards and recognition partner, Gift XOXO. Personality development partner, Three Fish Consulting. And of course, we are nearing to our cocktails and dinner. So our beer sponsor, United Breweries. Let's hear it for them, everybody. Thank you. Thank you once again for really being there and making this possible with us. Before we actually close, I'd like to take this opportunity. I'm sure many of you would have heard of it, but I'd like to introduce it at the Orientalist that 19th of January is another day to be marked on your calendar with the Total Rewards Conclave that we are coming up. This conclave is actually going to enable a lot of us deep dive and double click on various elements in human resource. That's what we are trying to do. So we really look forward to meeting you there. And the registrations are open. And there are festive offers because we are really nearing Christmas and New Year. So yes, festive offers are there too. Once again, a very big thank you to each one of you. And please do join us for cocktails and dinner right outside. Beer, again, brought to you by United Breweries. We are, the evening has been set, but it's yet to be celebrated outside. So really looking forward to joining each one of you right there. May I request all the winners with your trophies, all the jury members, all our partners, and our past winners to please join us up on the stage for a nice photograph. Let's hear it for one last time, ladies and gentlemen. Very good evening to each one of you. See you very soon. Thank you. Thank you very much. All our current winners, one announcement, quick announcement. We will have a video bite right outside here. So please do not forget to give your video bite and your experience. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, noted. Noted. May we have all the current winners, please, up on the stage. Okay, we can move up. Where are we? ...2016 winners, are you in the list?
Can we have Akansha and Savita as well to join us? Yes, sure. We have our partners as well. All our partners as well to come. Or do you want to do two photos first? Okay, we'll do two photos. I will call you.